So good morning, everyone. So again, we continue with the topic of MCG, which is moving coil galvanometer. Yesterday, we have spent some time understanding how it can be converted into ammeter. So today, we'll go through how a MCG can be converted into a voltmeter. Okay, so moment we think of MCG, and most cases, whether it works as a galvanometer, ammeter, or voltmeter, it is connected electrical circuit. So how should we view MCG? MCG is actually a resistance. And typically we denote its resistance as capital G. So it's like a resistor in a circuit. Only thing additional about MCG is it also has a pointer, which has angular displacement proportional to current. So since it is proportional to current, and this particular, it has a kind of indicator or needle attached, and this needle has a maximum particular angular displacement. And since this angle theta is maximum value is limited, the current also is limited, which limits the maximum allowable current. So MCG is a resistor with an indicator which is proportional to current. Okay, and maximum angular displacement is limited, has the current also limited. And we remember we got this equation based on equating two torques, one torque which is trying to rotate, other torque in form of a torsional spring which is trying to prevent this rotation. And that's what our understanding of MCG is. So let's try and understand what happens if we connect a MCG across two points with some potential difference. Moment we connect across two potential difference, it is equivalent to connecting a resistance across two potential difference points. So what would happen when the resistance is connected across two potential difference points? The current will start flowing. So similar way, current will start flowing in MCG also. And this current will correspond to what current, what would the value of current which will flow through the MCG? It will depend on the potential difference across two points is connected to. Okay, so what would the value of potential difference be? How would that potential difference and current flowing through galvanometer be related? V will be Ig into G. And this is the current flowing through the galvanometer. Small I is not the maximum value or whatever value of current which is flowing through galvanometer. And this I can be written in form of this value of current, which is proportional to theta. So when we substitute, so what we find, even here also what we find, the potential difference across the terminals of the MCG is proportional to theta. So since by measuring theta, we can measure value of V. Okay, so the wave, similar relationship, what holds good in case of current being proportional to theta? Similar way, since voltage is proportional to current, obviously it makes sense the voltage also is proportional to theta. So by measuring something like this is connected. Suppose these are two points on the circuit somewhere. These two points are A and B. And if a volt MCG is connected across these two points A and B, which has potential difference V, it will make current Ig flow through this galvanometer or MCG. And relationship between V, Ig, and G is this. That's the relationship. So nothing very surprising, very basic things. So here also, when we look at, again, we run parallel to similar to what we had done in case of galvanometer. So we have calculated current sensitivity. So when we want to measure voltmeter, the voltage, we want to understand what would be voltage sensitivity. The voltage sensitivity means per unit voltage measured, what is the angular displacement it will show. Larger the value of displacement of the measuring needle, more sensitive the equipment is. So something again, what is theta by V here? So theta by V also from here, we get value of theta by V from here is NAB by G into K. K is what? Torsional constant. So what we notice here, it is similar to what we had in case of a measurement of current. Only thing it gets divided by additional term called G, which is nothing but resistance of the galvanometer. So far similar. So what is the maximum value of current? What is the maximum value of voltage it can measure? See, this current, this is proportional. So when this becomes max, what is the maximum value of voltage corresponding to maximum value of angular displacement? Okay, so when, and see, corresponding to maximum angular displacement, there's a particular value of maximum current which can pass through the galvanometer, which you have seen in case of earlier cases also. So corresponding to maximum displacement, there's a current associated, and that associated current is called maximum current which can be allowed in the galvanometer. If the current exceeds that value, it may end up damaging the equipment. So current should not exceed the current corresponding to maximum angular displacement. So what is the maximum value of voltage it can measure? The value will be maximum when the current through galvanometer is maximum. And I have just to differentiate between the two. This IG is some value for some intermediate value, whereas capital IG indicate maximum value of current, which is allowed in a particular galvanometer. So range of a voltmeter, range of MCG, if it has to work as a voltmeter, is equal to G times IG. And we already seen this IG is extremely small value. So since this value is very small, even G into IG also becomes a small value. So it limits the maximum value of voltage it can measure because IG is limited, but it can work as a voltmeter. Okay. And one more point we briefly discuss here when we talk about sensitivity, another thing which comes into picture when we look at the sensitivity, see sometimes the question may come, if we increase number of turns in a MCG, if a coil has more number of turns, does it increase sensitivity? See, when these two terms are related, as N increases, same proportion G also will increase. So since both are related and they tend to cancel out to even, so if suppose from 100 turns, we convert into 200 turns, N will become double, G also will become double. Resistance of galvanometer also will double, assuming that entire resistance of galvanometer is in form of coils, which is mostly true. So since they are related, they tend to cancel out. Voltage sensitivity is independent of number of turns N as G increases in the same proportion. Unlike what happens in case of when it is current sensitivity. So this is something it can work, but we find it has certain limitations, similar to kind of limitation MCG has for measurement of current. So let's look at what those limitations are and what changes we need to carry out in MCG to make it suitable to work as a voltmeter. Okay. So this again, this what MCG is, now it's connected. The limitations are, we already seen, this is range is limited. And second problem is, see, whenever we have a voltmeter, when we connect across two points, and these two points have certain potential difference. So unless this, and it may be part of the circuit or something. So unless this resistance here is extremely large, the resistance of the circuit gets altered, and potential also gets altered. So what is necessary for the potential which is being measured does not change. It is necessary that resistance of voltmeter should be high, which is not the case in case of a galvanometer. So but these are two limitations. Range is limited and resistance is not very large. Unlike previous case, in case of ammeter, since it's connected in series, we want small resistance. Here it is connected in parallel. So here we want very large resistance. So these are the two corrections which you need to make. And all those corrections, both the correction can be done in one way. What is the one way we can convert? So to convert galvanometer into voltmeter, to meet both these limitations, a high resistance is connected in series. So if this resistance we want to increase, only way we can increase the resistance is by connecting additional resistance in series. So it becomes something like this. So this is something how MCG is. Moment we add a resistance, this resistance also become part of the galvanometer, and this whole setup can be called now as a voltmeter. So what is voltmeter? Voltmeter is a galvanometer with a suitable high resistance connected in series. Now to measure current, again, it can be connected across whichever point we want to measure potential difference. The voltmeter is always connected in parallel across the points where potential difference is to be measured. Now in this case, what will happen? So when the current IG, what does IG indicate? Maximum current what is flowing. So when current is maximum in the galvanometer, the voltage earlier it was V, now it becomes V dash. What is V equal to? V was equal to IG into G. So maximum value of range of MCG as a voltmeter was IG into G. Moment we add a resistance in series, V dash becomes different. V dash becomes equal to IG into what is potential difference now? IG into total resistance. Total resistance becomes G plus R. So equivalent resistance of the voltmeter is G plus R. Whole thing is a part of voltmeter. And what is the maximum range when current is maximum? So now the earlier range was V, now it becomes V dash. V dash is equal to how much? V dash is equal to IG. IG indicates the maximum current which is allowed in the moving coil galvanometer multiplied by total resistance, G plus R. So in order to increase by factor of N, what is factor of N? A new range divided by range as a galvanometer. V dash by V is a factor is N. What is that equal to? In that case, we easily notice this was G plus R into IG, that was G into IG. So factor by which a range increases is equal to new resistance divided by resistance as a MCG or galvanometer. So suppose we connect a resistance which is 9 times the resistance of galvanometer, its range will increase by a factor of 10. Similarly, if we connect a resistance which is 99 times value of resistance of galvanometer, the range will become 100 times. So we can easily calculate, depending on what increase in range we want, we can connect appropriate value of R. Depending on range, what are the range without any resistance connected in series, and this is with a high resistance connected in series. So larger the value, larger the value of RJ, R is greater the ranges. As the range keeps increasing, the resistance also keeps increasing. As the resistance keeps increasing, the error in measurement of volt, error in measurement of potential difference also in a way reduces. Because if the resistance of galvanometer is small, it alters the potential difference it is supposed to measure. Okay, so these are the key points, and very simple. I think all linked to what, similar to what we have seen in case of an. So read this question and see what difference we find and how do we interpret. This is in January cycle 2019 in mains, this question had come. What are the things which are given and what we need to find? The galvanometer has a resistance of 20 ohms. Value of G is given. What is the meaning of this word, 30 division on both sides? 30 division on both sides means sometimes galvanometer can work only one direction. It can also, we can also have a galvanometer which can work in either direction.
So direction of current will affect it.
Yes. So maybe that's, but only advantage of something which have division on both sides, we don't have to worry about polarity. Any other voltmeter, the polarity is important. It will have plus and minus sign. So suppose we have galvanometer. Do you remember somewhere we had to have use a galvanometer where we want to measure current in both directions? Have you used galvanometer somewhere which should have division in both sides? Have you used any such kind of galvanometer anywhere in the past?
Yes, sir.
Where?
Sir, in 10th class we did it.
No, even 11, recently also we did something. In case of Wheatstone bridge, even in case of potentiometer, what kind of galvanometer we need? We want to find the balancing length. The balancing length, to find the balancing length, we want to have zero reading. But there also, the to find balancing, sometimes the current is in one direction, sometimes the current is in the other direction. For all those experiments, we need a galvanometer which has divisions on both sides. Though we don't measure the current there, but we should have a galvanometer which can swing in either direction. The current can flow in either direction. Okay. Okay, so where do we are used? We are used in something like this in Wheatstone. There also we find balancing length, balancing condition. And we have also used, where else we are used? We also use in potentiometer. The potentiometer also, if you recall potentiometer, there also we use a galvanometer, which can, needle can move in either direction to indicate which direction the current is flowing. Okay, so if you recall potentiometer, something potentiometer wire. So if I connect at some point, I find here the reading is left hand side, it swings to left hand side. Some other point if I take, it moves to right hand side. So I understand the balancing point will be somewhere in between. Okay, this is what is given. If we swing on both sides, that is not important. But what we come across a new term which is normally not referred in most books. What is figure of merit? Let's see, but figure of merit, moment we look at many times, the unit will give an indication. What does figure of unit say? It's 0.0 ampere per division. So this also gives an indication for per division, the current is equal to 0.005 ampere, irrespective of what is mentioned here. So though figure of merit is a term we are not familiar with, we are not dealt with earlier, but unit indicates what does this term mean. Now, so this we understood. And so basically suppose in this question, though it is not asked, if I have to find what is IG, what is the maximum current which can be passed in this galvanometer? What is IG equal to? IG figure of merit is this many amperes per division. So this will be number. So it has 30 divisions on either side. So IG will be equal to current per division. So whenever we find current, we have to multiply with whatever quantity is there in the denominator into 30 divisions. And 30 divisions on either side. Only thing what is special about this, this current can be in either direction. It can be one direction. In the opposite direction also, we can do the same. This is IG is given. Now question is, what resistance that should be connected in series so that it can be used to measure, it can work as a voltmeter up to 15 volts. Once you understand this question, it's extremely simple. And this is something only, new term only was used as a figure of merit. So again, range is simple, nothing very surprising. Range is equal to when the current is maximum into R plus G. We put those values. So this question also was Payne's question. You notice this was an extremely easy question. 15 is equal to 0.005 into 30. And this is what we need to find. And value of G is given. Value of G is equal to 20. So all of you notice that this also is a fairly simple question. Okay. What is the value we get here?
80.
80? Yeah. So this is also a simple question and a time is going, but there are a few tricky questions as well. As we go along, we come across those questions. Okay, so if I erase those things, what I notice here? Yes, figure of merit is current per division, inverse of sensitivity. And that's what we'll keep in mind. And this question can easily be solved. Okay. Now we come to another one, which is, this question. So in this case, PS plus read through the question, then we'll go begin solving this one. Okay, I hope all of you read through. This part is simple. It has 150 divisions, that's fine. Now, what does this part mean? It has current sensitivity of 10 divisions per milliampere, which means when I pass a current of 1 milliampere, it will deflect by 10 divisions. That's what this sentence means, which is not too difficult to understand. And in terms of voltage also, see, whenever it has current, it has some potential difference voltage also. What does voltage sensitivity mean? So if a voltage potential difference is 1 millivolts, it will show a deflection of 2 divisions. Now this is this information given. So how it can be designed to read first 6 amperes per division? So how it has to be designed for this kind of ammeter? How it has to design this kind of voltmeter? So this question also is a conversion of an MCG into ammeter and voltmeter. Both the things are combined into one, but information is given in slightly different form. Okay, so let's go through one by one. How do we examine this question? First of all, I hope all of you understand what these two things mean. Okay, and let's see how do we go about solving this. Okay, so what we understand, suppose when you have to design this ammeter also. And let's try to recall, we work back. You have to design ammeter, so I can either, we can take current for maximum deflection with the with modification, and what is IG? And that's a either we can take maximum value of currents or we can take currents per division also. Both ways you can take. So what is I here? Let's take. What is the maximum value of current it has to measure? I'll just come to the per division part again. So maximum current after modification or after conversion of MCG into ammeter, it has to measure a current of 6 ampere per division. So maximum current is 6 into 150. Okay. What is the maximum current which can pass through in MCG without any shunt being added? This also we can work out. See, maximum current for 10 division current is 1 milliampere. Okay, so 1 milliampere produces 10 divisions. Total number of divisions are 150. It means what is IG? What is the maximum current which can be passed in the galvanometer when the deflection becomes maximum? It will be 15 times of this. So what is IG equal to? IG is equal to 1 milliampere into 15. So this is something I think you understand this what is given. So either I could have taken a total value or I could have taken as per division. Both will give me the same ratio. Per division means I would not have taken number of divisions. Both will give the same thing. And this value is equal to G plus by S. That's my formula. Okay. In this formula, what is given and what is not given? Let's again divide it into this. Is the resistance given? See, to apply this formula, I need value of G here. Then only can find S. But from this information, can we find G here? G is not given in the question. Can we find G? Can we find the resistance of MCG here? What do we need to find resistance to find G? G is nothing but resistance. What are things we need to find resistance? I need current and corresponding voltage. If I know value of current and corresponding voltage, I can find value of G. So is this corresponding value of current and voltage are given? You can easily find. We can find the value of, see, current should be given, for a given voltage, what is the corresponding current also we should know. Both should be corresponding to each other. Okay, so how do we find that information? So we can check, if you have to a corresponding value, it means I need to take the current as well as voltage for same deflection. When the deflection is same, so what is the current and what is the voltage? If I know both the things, using their ratio, I can find out resistance of the galvanometer. So this, can we find this value of current and voltage for same deflection or one division? For one division, what is the current here? For 10 divisions, current is 1 milliampere. So one division, what is the current? 0.1 milliampere. And for one division, what is the voltage? When it shows, when MCG has a deflection of one division, what is the current and what is the voltage? That's what we are trying to find out. Because once we know the current and corresponding voltage, I can find out resistance of the MCG. So current per dip for one division is equal to 0.1 milliampere. Similarly, if the for one division, what is the voltage? For two division, it is 1 millivolt. So for one division, voltage will be equal to 0.5 millivolts. So these are for the same value. These are the corresponding value. Based on these two, can we find out value of G? Now we can find out G. What is G equal to? V by I. V by I, both are milli. So G value comes equal to 5 volts. So all this information indirectly was giving me value of G. Once I have value of G here, I can find out what is the resistance, what is the shunt I need to connect to convert it into an ammeter. For ammeter, this ratio, I can write this ratio. This ratio is 6 into milli, but so this becomes 10. 10 into 10 to power 3, it becomes 6 into 10 to power 4. Is equal to 5 plus G. The value of G is 5 plus S divided by S. And since S is, this is very, okay. S is since like very, very small. This number is very large, so I can ignore this one value. So this is equivalent to 5 by S. What is S equal to? I can easily calculate. What is value of S comes to here? S is equal to 5 by 6 into 10 to power minus 4, or I can write as 50 by 6 into 10 to power minus 5, which is equivalent to something like 8.3 into 10 to power minus 5. So once the key part of the question was to find the value of G. Similar way, now we have to design this voltmeter also. The voltmeter also, again, I can take similar ratio of what is voltmeter. V dash by V. What is V dash? Either I can take for the full deflection, I can take for one division. V dash is equal to 1 volt per division. And what was V before resistance was added? It was equal to, for one division, it was equal to 0.5 millivolts. So 1 volt divided by 0.5 millivolt is, so range is proportional to the resistance of the voltmeter. This is after addition of resistance R in series, resistance becomes G plus R. And this was the reading per division when only resistance was in form of galvanometer resistance. So range, voltmeter range ratio is same as resistor ratio of the resistance. So once I have this equation, I can easily calculate G value is known, R also can be calculated. Okay, so I hope this part also is clear. Which is a very good question, which has come in the examination in the past. So you can notice some of the question can be a little challenging. All right, sorry. What has happened? Order has changed. Okay. So this is a question given. This is a question. The actual value of resistance R shown in the figure is 30 ohms. So this is a figure given. Here R is, actual value of R is 30 ohms. This is measured in an experiment as showing using standard formula R is equal to VI. So what in this experiment? This resistance is connected. There's a battery here. There's an ammeter connected here, which will show the current value. There's a voltmeter connected here, which will show potential difference across these two points. Okay. So what we done? We recorded value of current here and recorded value of I voltage here. And R was calculated using formula V by I, where V and I are the readings of voltmeter and ammeter. If the measured value of R is 5% less than the actual value, then what is the internal resistance of the voltmeter? This was the question. Unfortunately, I put in the wrong order, so my hints also have come on the screen, but try to solve with the hint as well. So actual value of resistance is 30 ohms, but if I calculate R as V by I, V by I is the reading of voltmeter and ammeter, it is found to be 5% less. Then what is the internal resistance of the voltmeter? So take a couple of minutes to think how you want to let's understand one by one this question. See, whenever you have a resistance, how do you find out a resistance? Suppose I have a resistance here. If I have resistance here, so let's take a resistance here. If in this resistance, I apply some potential difference and we measure the value of current which is flowing through. If I can measure potential difference as well as I, then its resistance will be equal to V by I. So at a particular time, but the both has to be corresponding value. It doesn't matter what it was, but this is something we can find. So what has to be, potential difference has to be across the resistor, and current, what is this V? V has to be across the resistor. And what has to be I? Current flowing through the resistor. I is through the resistor. Now let's look at what they have done here. Second thing, what we need to understand is point, I think, is a little bit mentioned. So whenever we connect a resistance, so basically suppose we know any circuit. So again, we come, so this voltmeter, is this voltmeter showing the correct potential difference across resistance or not? Even if it is, this is clearly the resistance, since we have to find internal resistance of the voltmeter, naturally voltmeter is not ideal one. If voltmeter is not ideal one, does it mean it shows a wrong potential difference? Let's try and understand that part. Okay, so this is also important part to understand. Let's take another example. Suppose there's a circuit here, which has two resistances. Okay. Let's say this one was R and this was 2R. Okay, and this is V. So what would happen if I take these 2 points, the potential difference between two of them, where VAB would have been equal to 2V by 3, right? Now suppose I connect a voltmeter here. If I connect a voltmeter, which is not ideal, this voltmeter is equal to, say this voltmeter has resistance of 10R. Now it will measure some potential difference between A and B. This potential difference, now after voltmeter is connected, the potential difference will change. It will not remain VAB. It becomes VAB dash. Why does it change? Because resistance will change and current will change, potential difference between A and B will change. This voltmeter will measure the correct value of potential difference in this particular circuit. It measures the value of potential difference between A and B in the current state, not in the state which existed before voltmeter was connected. It alters the potential difference, but still it measures current value of potential difference, current value of potential difference. Okay, so that's what I say. So even in non-ideal, suppose we connect here. So whenever you have an ammeter, it will always measure the current correct value of current passing through it. Though the current might have changed after the ammeter is connected, it will read the correct changed value. This also will read correct potential change potential difference. Okay, so that's what I say. So even in non-ideal, voltmeter and ammeter reads correct value of potential difference and current, though it may not be same as the one which existed before voltmeter or ammeter was connected. In this case, are we concerned about what are the potential difference between these 2 points? We are not concerned. So it is measuring, since the voltmeter is connected across A and B, voltmeter reading will give you the correct value of potential difference in this particular instance across resistance R. This is correct. Now problem comes with the current. So current also should have been passing through resistance R, but this current is being measured here, not in this branch. That's why the error is coming. The first part, not that this is important point. Ashray, have you understood this point?
Yes, sir. Got it.
You got the point here? And this important point, I think this point may become useful in several other questions later on. So measure value will be correct if the voltmeter is connected across the resistor only and ammeter measures current through it properly. Okay. Okay, so that's where problem comes in. So let's try and analyze better now. So we have, so far what we understood why the error has come. Now let's analyze more detail, how we convert into a mathematical equation. Okay. So this is circuit now. So let the current be, so let's say this current, let this current be I, and this current is IR, and this current is IB. Naturally, I will be equal to IB plus IR. So what would have been, what would have given me correct potential difference, sorry, correct value of R? Correct value of R is what? Can we define the correct value of R now? What is the measured value of R and what is the correct value of R? Can someone tell me what is the measured value of R based on this V reading, IV, I and IR? What is the correct value of R? Based on these values. Disha, can you tell me correct value of R based on these readings where these parameters here? What will be the correct value of R? Okay, let me write that one, no, it doesn't matter. V divided by R is the correct value. Does it make sense now? Potential difference, if this is giving correct value of potential difference between these two points. So correct value of R is this. And what is this equal to? This is equal to 30 ohms. What is measured value of R here?
V by I.
Is equal to V by I. And I is what? I is greater than IR. What is I? I is equal to IR plus IV. Since I is greater, hence the measured value is smaller than the actual value. How much is smaller? It's lesser by 5%. So lesser by 5% means. So these are the two equations. Have you understood these two equations? Disha, have you understood these two points?
Yes, sir. Hmm?
So now can we find, based on this information, what is the value of IV plus RV? Sorry, IV plus IV. Now, based on this equation, can we find the value of this R is 30? Can we find the resistance of voltmeter? I think that should be able to find. So when we read this one, so clearly V is not ideal. If it were ideal, if this was ideal, if voltmeter had been ideal, I would have been equal to IR. You understand this point? If a voltmeter was ideal, then I would have been equal to IR and IV would have been zero. You would have got the correct reading. Is this point also understood? Is this understood clearly, Ashray?
Yes, sir.
If a voltmeter was ideal, what would have happened? The current, this one would have been zero. If the current would have been zero, even this current also would have been same as IR, I would have got the correct value of R. The reason I'm not getting correct value of R, because first of all, my design is a little faulty, and secondly, voltmeter is not ideal. That's an additional point you can understand from this question. Now I move to the next point. What is the equation we form? These are the two equations we form. Based on the equation, can I find the value of R now? Sorry, can we find the value of RV? I'll give you again a minute, so see whether you can find the value of. So those from here onwards should have been very simple. When the ratio of current is given, we can always write the current in a particular branch in terms of total incoming current and ratio of these two resistances. Very easy. I think from there onwards should not be difficult at all. Most of you should have been should have found the answer by now. So I can write what is IR equal to, current in a particular resistance is equal to what? Is equal to the opposite resistance RV. I is equal to, but the current in resistance of RV divided by sum of the two resistance into I, which is equal to 28.58 by 30. And this is something, this equation we form here. Once we form this equation, R is given as 30. We solve RV equal to 570. So that's the solution for this question. And